solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Thank you, Neil, raise your hand and have a seat. Could you please state your name for the jury?
I'm Ralph Hudgens.
And how are you employed, Mr. Hudgens?
I'm the insurance commissioner for the state of Georgia.
And is that a statewide role?
It is.
And how long have you been serving in that position?
I'm in my seventh year.
And were you serving in this position in August of 2014?
I was.
And do you recall attending any political rallies or campaign events during August of 2014?
Many.
And in particular, on August 23rd of 2014, do you recall attending an event at Burke's Pumpkin Farm here in Dawsonville?
I do.
Now, if you could tell us, do you recall who invited you to this event?
I think it was the Dawson County Republican Party.
Do you remember who with the Dawson County Republican Party?
No.
Do you recall approximately how long before August 23rd that you were invited?
I wouldn't have any idea.
And do you recall when the invitation was extended, did you talk to the person who invited you about audio and video recording of the event?
No.
Did you make any requests of this person about no audio video recording?
No.
Did they tell you there were going to be any rules in place about recording?
No.
Was it your impression that this was a public campaign rally?
Yeah, sure. I mean, it was for anyone, I guess, that the Dawson County Republican Party wanted to invite.
And did you know about any advertisements for it on Facebook, other social media, newspaper?
No.
Now, when you traveled to the event on August 23rd, did you bring any campaign staffers or aides with you?
No, I brought my wife to talk. Okay.
So you and your wife drove up on on Saturday the 23rd?
Right.
August. And did you recall about what time you got there? Was it, you know, right before the event started? Was it much earlier than the event?
I think it was just prior to it beginning. I know that we walked in and kind of looked around at the store and then went back into the area where the event was being held.
And had you been to Burke's Pumpkin Farm before?
No.
So when you and your wife arrived, were there a lot of other officials and candidates around?
I can't remember specifically, but yes, there were several, you know, and we kind of trooped around the state together, and you know, we exchanged pleasantries.
And were you coming from another event earlier in the day?
I don't recall that.
So when you arrived, did you see anyone videotaping?
No.
Did you see any signs about videotaping?
No.
Did you talk to anyone at the event when you first got there, you and your wife?
Well, of course.
Well, so who did you talk to?
I have no idea, but I try to speak to everyone.
Do you recall speaking to my client, Nydia Tisdale?
No.
Did you recognize Nydia Tisdale?
No.
Did you see, now that you are looking at her now, do you recall seeing her as you came into the event?
No.
When was the first time you recall noticing Ms. Tisdale?
When I was speaking.
And now, were you the first speaker up that day?
I can't remember. I was one of the very first, I know, because I had to go to another event down in Bexar County.
And so, did you leave right after your speech?
Yes.
Now, before you spoke publicly in the word shed, did you have any conversations with the owners of the property about expectations for video or audio recording?
No.
Did you tell them, I don't want anybody recording?
No.
Did your wife tell you that?
You'll have to ask her, but I don't think so.
Just asking, obviously, if anything happened in your presence, I don't want to hear anything that did not happen within your presence. So did you hear anyone,
No.
Did any staffers or people who worked for other candidates, did any of them come up to you you would have talked to you about video or audio recording?
No.
Did any of them tell you anything whatsoever about video or audio recording?
No.
Were you concerned that somebody might be recording?
No, ma'am.
When you first noticed someone recording, did you want them to stop?
No.
Did it make you feel intimidated?
No.
As a public official, did you have a problem with being videotaped?
No.
I'm going to object to that last question. There's a relative of him having a problem being videotaped.
And, Your Honor, I think there has been testimony.
Come up.
Move to strike, Judge, please.
All right, members of the court. The objection has been sustained, therefore the last statement on, well, the question is not evidence. If the witness made an answer to that question, you were to disregard it and not concern yourselves with it.
Thank you, Your Honor. And at this time, I'm going to show you what's been marked as State's Exhibit 2, previously admitted. And Commissioner Hudgens, have you viewed a videotape of your remarks that day, August 23rd, 2014?
No, ma'am.
So if before or after the governor's speech before everyone leaves, we'll announce who's the door prize winner. Somebody's going to get to take home a giant pumpkin, a pumpkin farm without a giant pumpkin. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to our insurance commissioner, Mr. Ralph Hudgens. We're really glad to have Commissioner Hudgens with us today. He's done a great job on the ballot this fall, and we'll let Commissioner Hudgens go from there. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you for being here today. Thank you for helping us re-elect a complete Republican ticket. I tell you, for the first time ever, we've got a Republican in every office, and we need to keep it that way. In the insurance world, my battle right now, really not my battle, but what I get accused of having a battle.
I'm just going to pause that for a moment, Commissioner Hudgens. Does it look like the camera is zooming in on you a little bit there?
Yeah.
Did that bother you in any way?
No.
Did that intimidate you?
No.
At this point, could you see that someone was videotaping?
I don't think I spotted the camera or noticed. I didn't spot. I hadn't noticed the camera at that time.
Is Obamacare. But let me tell you, Obamacare is a total, total disaster. If you want to get a quick glimpse of what Obamacare is going to result in, if we don't repeal it, look at what's happening in the Veterans Administration. That's exactly what's going to happen with us if we don't repeal this. Now, I'm not saying let's just repeal it and do away with it. We need to repeal it and replace it. And there are some, Congressman Price, Tom Price from Georgia, has a wonderful plan, but we need to take an incremental approach to this problem we have with health care. We don't need an omnibus bill that does everything in the world like this one tried to do. You know, the president has delayed in this bill 71 different times. He has said, well, this is what the bill says, and then he changes his mind and he delays it. Governor, that doesn't happen in our state. I was in the legislature for 14 years. Every time we passed a bill, then we sent it to the governor. If the governor signed it, then it became law, and we expected the agency that it applied to uniformly enforce that bill and do what it says. But President Obama says that, well, I can just, I don't like this part, so we're going to delay it, and I think it's time we call his hands. I hope that I see our nominee for Senator David Perdue back here. We've got to elect David to help us get the majority in the U.S. Senate. If we can get the majority in the Senate and maintain the majority in the House, which we will, Congressman Collins is here.
I'm right.
Wherever he is, there he is. He's doing a great job, but we can maintain that majority, get the majority in the Senate, then we can call his bluff. Right now, Harry Reid is being an absolute obstructionist on everything that is a good piece of legislation, and we need to do our part. The only part we can do is to make sure that David Perdue is elected and Michelle Dunn is not. And I'm not going to get into that race, but I was at the I was at the Chamber of Commerce event where David and Michelle had a debate, and I have never seen anybody misrepresent their stands as much as Michelle Dunn did. All she wanted to do is talk about, we need to have a team, we need to have consensus building, we need this and that. And I thought I was going to have to resuscitate my wife. I thought she was going to pass out, and I thought I was going to absolutely puke listening to her. I mean, I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that.
Can you tell us, from your perspective, what was happening when you were making these statements?
what was happening?
In the crowd, what did you notice that caused you to make that statement?
I felt like the crowd was enjoying what I was having to say. And, you know, I was just kind of giving a campaign speech.
And did you notice anyone filming you at that time?
Yes, I pointed her out. I said, I don't know why you're videotaping this, but yes, I said, puke.
And so you did not recognize the person who was filming at that point?
No.
But now do you recognize that that person was Ms. Nydia Tisdale?
I do.
And once you noticed her in the audience, filming you with a video camera, did that change your mind about giving a campaign speech?
No.
Did it intimidate you or make you want to stop?
No.
Did it seem like she was, were you worried she was going to take something out of context?
No. Chairman of the party or whatever, I just don't recall.
Well, of those conversations involve you requesting not to be videotaped?
No.
Or you gotta get rid of that videotaper?
No.
Or can I get a copy of that tape so we can destroy it?
No. I didn't say anything I was ashamed of.
And as a public official, do you expect to be recorded when you're speaking to the public?
Absolutely.
Well, I don't have any further questions for you at this point, Commissioner. Thank you so much for being here. The Assistant District Attorney may have some.
Thank you, ma'am.
And Your Honor, with your permission, I will leave this up here for the next witness. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Judges.
Good afternoon.
Lynn, did you have staffers working with you at this event?
No.
Do you know the man named Matt Burgess?
Not right off.
What about Neil Biden? Is that anything you got? Brad Hughes?
I know of Brad Hughes.
Long time ago, right?
It was. A lot of water under the bridge.
Sure, it sure was. Now, did you actually recall speaking with any of the Burks, Johnny or Kathy Burke, or anyone like
that? I think I spoke with her when I got there. I got there a few minutes early, and but like I say, when it was over, I left because I was supposed to be at this Bear County event.
When you go to state, did you utilize staffers?
No.
You did?
Yeah.
Are you familiar with staffers? In general, folks working, we'll say political representatives, political coordinators, field representatives, those folks?
Sure.
Okay. Are you familiar with the concept of a political tracker or a Democrat tracker, someone that follows?
I've had that done to me before.
So, is that something typically the candidates are concerned with? Political trackers following?
I would object to the general nature of the question, or I think if he wants to ask if this witness is concerned by it, but I don't think the witness would be able to speculate as to everyone else's concern.
I would object to that. Are you concerned about political trackers following you, sir?
Not really. If you tell the truth, you don't have to worry about it.
Great answer. That's right. Now, I want to go back to this video if you don't bear with me.
Okay.
Now, if I understood you correctly, you believe you spoke to, stopped by, spoke to the police officer.
It seems like that there was a police officer. In my mind's eye, I see kind of a walkway with a rail, and I see a police officer and somebody standing there, and I just stopped briefly, and then I went to the car and headed to Bear County.
Okay. Get back to where we just was.
All right.
That makes any sense? Second, Mr. Hudgens, I won't be long because I will meet you out here.
Recognize this person. That's the way he's in there. I need to get over 50% of the vote with your help. That'll happen. And with your help, we'll be able to keep our Republican ticket. And I want to introduce a friend of mine, Richard Woods. Richard is who I supported in the primary because he was opposed to Common Core, and I'm opposed to Common Core, and so I supported him. But Richard Woods is our the candidate for school superintendent, and let's give him a warm Dawson County welcome.
Well, again, one of the good things here that if I guess Mr. Hudgens does lose his cookies, I've worked at an elementary school, so I have experience that I can
You walked around to where those gentlemen were. You saw that, correct?
I saw him walk right in front of that truck.
Right.
There were some gentlemen there?
That one's back up.
I've worked at an elementary school, so.
You see you right here in the corner?
Yeah.
Let's keep watching.
Well, I have experience that I can.
That isn't good anymore. I'll back it up one more time, Sheriff. I'm not picking at you, I promise.
Okay.
Well, again, one of the good things here that.
Do you see over on the right hand? I guess if we're facing right on the right hand side, there's be a gentleman with a hat on.
Right.
The MC we saw start the whole, I guess, rally. Do you recall whether he was over there?
I don't recall. I don't see him there.
Right. Do you recall if that's when you met the police officer and whoever it was you spoke to?
I thought that I met the police officer back up this ramp. I'm not sure if that's the way out. I met the police officer on the way out. I saw the police officer. I didn't meet him.
Right, but
if I guess Mr. Hudgens does lose his cookies, I've worked at an elementary school, so.
Now, were you pointing at anyone when you raised your hand up? Do you remember?
When I raised my hand, when?
I'm sorry, Mr. Hudgens, I should.
Okay.
And we'll warm Dawson County welcome. Well, again, one of the good things here that if I guess Mr. Hudgens does lose his cookies, I've worked at an.
Let's take a look at it.
There as I was leaving.
In
and I stopped and I said something, and I don't remember, I couldn't begin to tell you what I said. But then we walked on out and walked through the store and got the car and went to Winder.
Was Dawson County Rally your first stop of the day?
I believe so.
You need to go all the way down to Winder.
Winder.
Okay, so, do you remember what you did prior to coming to that rally that morning? No further questions, thank you.
Just very briefly, Commissioner Hudgens, when you said you saw the police officer talking to somebody, do you remember if it was a man or a woman?
I do not.
Do you remember if it looked like there was any kind of fight or altercation going on?
No.
It did not?
No.
Like that?
No.
Okay. And do you remember hearing any screams or loud noises or yelling?
No. The first I knew anything about this is when I went to Winder and I spoke, and somebody, and I don't know who it is, somebody came to me and said, "You missed all the fireworks."
That's your say. Somebody came to me and said.
And the assistant district attorney is entirely correct. Thank you very much, Commissioner Hudgens. I don't have any further questions.
May I go back to my office?
Yes, sir.
Do you want to excuse this witness?
Yes, ma'am.
You're excused.
Thank you, ma'am.
You may go back to your office.
All right, I'm going to go back and do the people's work.